Hey, play the piano. It sounds so pretty. Perfect. You are the best.
It was very clear that this was a gifted child.
You're 6 years old. I just want to remind you of that. Okay.
I like Mozart because he's kind of like me and I'm kind of like him.
She has fulfilled a lot of the potential that she showed at that age.
She's really a genetic explosion.
There's not a day that my jaw doesn't drop from her.
I worry all the time. She's 11 years old.
She is a class act and just a fabulous musician.
She has a gift for knowing how music works with moving image.
Right now she wants to be soundtrack composer like John Williams.
I think of myself more as a composer than a concert pianist.
Obama calls her baby Mozart. When I heard her, I thought it was a miracle.
Quincy is a really, really good person.
Where do you see her in 10 years?
Wherever she wants to go.
This is the story of a little girl who was born with a gift. And she opened that gift early.
This comes out to me. This comes out.
Where does it come from?
I don't know. Probably in my heart.
You could call her a piano prodigy, though the P word is never used in the Bear home.
This is all unknown territory for all of us. I've heard about kids like this. I never thought I'd have one.
Her siblings, 12-year-old Benji and 7-year-old Lauren, are also talented musicians.
My brother plays electric and acoustic guitar. My sister plays the harp and piano, and I only play the piano. But I would like to play the flute.
Emily was discovered 4 years ago by her grandmothers. One of them a concert pianist who's made a career of teaching musically gifted children, like Emily.
I just love music. It's my passion.
4 years ago, Emily's mom and dad took a trip and left Grandma in charge. She heard someone playing piano and thought it was the eldest child.
I was overwhelmed. It was the baby, who was 2 years old and 1 month, playing a C scale with three fingers.
Play your scale, Emmy.
Grandma Murrow immediately contacted the prestigious Juilliard School of Music in New York.
He said, there's only one person in the country. His name is Emilio Del Rosario. He teaches at the Music Institute of Chicago.
With instruction from Del Rosario and many generous mentors, including Mary Sauer, the Chicago Symphony's principal keyboardist, Emily has blossomed. They're practicing Mozart's Concerto No. 23 that Emily will play next March with the Rockford Symphony Orchestra.
What she does in her music, in all the styles that she plays in, she is speaking directly from inside of her. Which is why jazz is so comfortable for her.
Yet her favorite song is not jazz or Mozart, but one she wrote herself for Mr. D, her loving piano teacher, who is now ill.
What do you want to be when you grow up?
Composer. I like Mozart because he's kind of like me and I'm kind of like him.
Like her playing, Emily's composing pours from her heart. It's her patience with fumble-fingered adults like me she has to work on. With keyboard chops that would be the envy of most adults, it's easy to forget Emily is still a child.
But this one is my favorite. Do you know why?
Why?
I got it at the White House.
What is your hope for her?
To be happy.
Yeah.
Seriously, to have good values, to be at peace in her heart, to be a really good grown-up.
But But until then, the one thing Emily wants you to know...
Actually, I'm just a normal kid that plays piano. And most, I like inspiring kids.
You know, we did this story on you, and we had no idea that millions and millions of people were going to watch it. You've seen the numbers, haven't you?
Yeah, I think it's up to like 23 million now.
Does that surprise you?
Yeah.
What kind of response did you all get to it?
Incredibly positive. From every which way, it just seemed to have a life of its own. Online, I would really see the response to it. And people would always mention it. If we ran into anybody and they knew about Emily, they'd be like, oh, that was the first and only story they would always mention.
Another change that happened was Emily's introduction to one of the world's greatest music producers,
yeah.
Quincy Jones. Do you think he saw that video?
Yes, he did, actually. It was the first one that was shown to him.
I'd like you to give up all the love in the room for Emily Bear. Emily! Please, knees. Emily. Emily Bear.
How are you?
Surprising.
Yep.
I'm so happy.
We're just in time for the sound check.
Huh?
You and Quincy clicked immediately, didn't you?
He's so down to earth that, like, he's like one of the world's biggest and best arrangers and producers kind of fell away, and he was just like, an awesome guy, walking encyclopedia of jazz.
And just like that, the 11-year-old from Rockford, Illinois, a child of this century, forges a bond with an 80-year-old music mogul with 27 Grammys. Quincy Jones produced Emily's latest CD and is in New York for her East Coast release concert. She composed and performed all 13 tracks on the CD called Diversity, and she's playing alongside some world-class jazz musicians, hand-picked by Jones. Not since 1987 has Quincy Jones produced a CD for a solo artist. The album Bad turned out pretty good for Michael Jackson.
He produced Michael Jackson.
That's so cool.
What do you think he sees when he hears you?
I'm not sure. What he told me last time, which really made me feel awesome, is that when he hears me play, that he always knows that I put a lot of work into it.
So how does a child understand how big a deal Quincy Jones really is?
To understand the immensity of what he has accomplished, both as a musician and a composer and a producer in every genre almost of music you can imagine. And I think Emily was really intrigued by that because she's not just one style of music, and she found a kindred spirit in Quincy when she saw that.
Quincy was introduced to us by a mutual friend, and he met Emily, and when he had the opportunity to play with her and listen to her play, they kind of developed a special bond.
Magical. We walked into the living room, and Quincy was there, and he had one of Emily's songbooks open, and he was playing Emily's music on the piano.
Then Quincy asked Emily to play for him, and she chose a version of Fly Me to the Moon that Frank Sinatra made famous.
Fly me to the moon.
Little did she know that Quincy Jones himself had arranged that song more than a half century earlier. Emily says Quincy told her, there's no such thing as a coincidence.
A coincidence is just God's way of remaining anonymous.
In other words,
do you believe that?
Hold my hand.
Their bond isn't just music, it's jazz. But this man, who is famous for breaking down the walls of musical genres, knows just how critical it is for Emily to build her musical base with the classics.
He insists that she continue her piano in classical training. He appreciates the value of that.
So notice the crescendo.
And that's where Mary Sauer comes into the musical mix.
Okay, too much pedal. You don't need any pedal.
She's principal keyboardist for the Chicago Symphony Orchestra and has been mentoring Emily since the age of 6.
She has fulfilled a lot of the potential that she showed at that age. She has grown physically, so now we are able to do repertoire that she was not able to do then. Her musical understanding is way beyond an 11-year-old. She always was interested in composing for film, so that we knew way early on. When I introduced her to John Williams, this is the question she asked him. How do you get your music on paper? And he said, I write every note, and her face just fell because she realized she just was going to have to do it by hand.
Now, the girl from Rockford handwrites her compositions too, and works not only with world-renowned mentors in the Midwest and Quincy Jones on the West Coast, but she's learning songwriting, orchestration, and film scoring from brilliant musical minds in New York, from Juilliard and New York University's Steinhardt.
Film scoring is really not offered in many places, period, which is an odd thing. At least seems to me, because it's certainly the world's most heard music.
This really works.
NYU professor Ron Sadoff runs the only graduate-level songwriting program in the world.
So they contacted, and as I'm talking with Andrea, I don't think I caught the fact that Emily was like 8 at the time. She has a gift for knowing how music works with moving image. She'll take, in the course of a day here, a 3-hour lesson at Juilliard with a jazz teacher, with a piano teacher, with me, with an orchestrator, with an endless, boundless energy.
That boundless energy, along with her musical gifts, earned Emily a spot among 20 composers chosen worldwide for a workshop this summer at NYU Steinhardt. Emily is the youngest composer ever selected.
It's an organic, it's a dramatic, and it's a narrative sense that she shouldn't have at that age.
Each composer was asked to write and orchestrate a scene from one of 3 Hollywood feature films. Emily chose the 2005 sci-fi film Serenity, rated PG-13. It's a film she's still too young to see. In the audience to hear Emily's music, composers from Homeland, The X-Files, and the Naked Gun series.
We've been so honored to have mentors that are not only incredibly skilled in their fields, but they have huge hearts and are just really, really good people. So Quincy is the top of that list.
The little girl who was just beginning to blossom as a composer when we visited her 5 years ago has come into full bloom. Emily Bear is homeschooled and spends hours a day not only practicing her instrument, but perhaps more importantly, composing.
She could compose 20 songs for you right now, and glad you're here today. Yeah, they just come out. After performances, she's composing all over the place.
I worry all the time. She's 11 years old. She's obviously getting a lot of attention. Our goal is to cultivate her musical talent, but at the same time, raise a well-adjusted young adult that can make good decisions.
Our job as a family is keeping the values and the kid grounded.
They've always supported me, and they've always been there for me.
That's the finished version.
Emily has performed at the White House, Carnegie Hall, and she's accepted invitations to perform all over the world.
So what's the next travel?
This summer we're going all around Europe because Emily is going on tour with Quincy Jones.
So far, China and Italy are their favorite trips. And schedules permitting, the whole family gets to go. Emily's brother and sister, Ben and Lauren, are musical too.
I hear her practice all the time, but then, like, now that when I go to her concerts, I'm just like, oh my god, like, whoa.
Well, I taught it to you at 8. She reaches into your heart. She talks to everybody almost like she's speaking to them through her music personally. And people have the same reaction all over the world.
And remember, it was Grandma Merle who first discovered the girl with the gift at the age of 2. Merle, the pianist who has taught gifted children her entire adult life, learned her own granddaughter was the most gifted child she'd ever seen.
She's really a genetic explosion. And I've used that term because it makes sense, because our genetics and music go all the way back into Europe.
Knowing the family, to some extent, her father, you know, is an orthopedic surgeon.
This is a metal plate, and then the screws go through the plate.
You can see that what he does has this almost unbelievable extent of concentration. Andrea, her mother, there's such a, she just exudes this musicality. And you know, it's she's not a stage mother whatsoever. This is the opposite of that.
Emily told us 5 years ago, she loves inspiring kids.
Teaching gifted children, they ask me now, Emily doesn't have to practice because she's so good and she's so gifted and she's so this. And I said, oh yes, she does. She practices 4 hours. 4 hours.
Emily's work ethic is one of the many things that impressed legendary music composer and producer Quincy Jones.
She knows what she's doing. She's worked. You have to work, man. The work is imperative.
He said, like, you can't just think you have it all. You still have to work.
How have you become a better musician, a better pianist?
I mean, he's taught me things, and he's taught me a lot of life lessons. Your music is only as good as the person you are.
What do you think you meant by that?
Like, that you're not going to get anywhere if you're mean or conceited.
She's used to the discipline of working hard like that, or she wouldn't have that kind of technique, that kind of sense of rhythmic control. She's like a 30-year-old, a 40-year-old adult, you know?
Yeah.
Amazing. And I work with everybody. Everybody. I really have.
Quincy's been one of the biggest blessings we could ever ask for. He's incredibly grounded, wise, sage. As we always say, he's like a Yoda of music. People don't know, he's scored 37 films alone.
And so it is the 80-year-old legend becomes a musical muse for the girl Prodigy, who hopes to follow in his film scoring footsteps.
I think the thing that he sees in Emily is complete connection with music, that true music, not just looping a disco beat, but truly someone who creates and makes and loves and lives in the world of music.
Here in New York at Les Poissons Rouges in Greenwich Village, Emily and her fellow musicians are rehearsing for tonight's East Coast CD release concert. And it seems Emily Bear is about to have the time of her 11-year-old life. It's a big night for the little girl with a gift from Rockford, Illinois, performing at an intimate jazz venue in New York's Greenwich Village. She appears totally unaffected.
Miss the door?
Even though Quincy Jones and all his star power will be here at any moment.
Tell me about the new CD you have.
It's called Diversity, and Quincy produced it, and there's 13 tracks, and...
You know what? Quincy's coming down the stairs.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Wait, let me say hi.
Hold on. You give him mine?
Congratulations. Beautiful, beautiful, natural human being. And humility with the creativity, which she has plenty of, and grace with the success. That's the secret.
Quincy Jones signed Emily Bear in 2011 when she was just 9 years old. He co-produced the CD she's releasing this night to a New York audience, filled with family, fans, and a who's who in the world of composing.
He was there for every step of the process, and he helped a lot. But he let me make the choices, which is really cool. The songs all evolved even throughout the recording process. Emily would hear something and go with it, and that's always the incredible magic, especially being with Quincy, is to hear what happens in the recording session that you can't predict until you're there in the moment.
She's joined this night by guest cellist Zuel Bailey, who also plays on her CD, as well as drummer Francisco Mela and bass player Peter Slavov.
Well, did you notice that she was conducting the group, that they were respecting her, that she was in charge, this 11-year-old child of grown men? I thought that was amazing.
Emily named this Latin jazz tune for one of her paternal grandmother's favorite foods, hot peppers. Emily and Quincy share a love of jazz, and he has said he sees a little of himself in her. It's a full house. Among those in the audience, Emily's mentors from NYU and Juilliard.
her gift is the fact that in jazz, in classical, in film scoring, in songwriting, if anybody could do it all, Emily would be the one.
It's just so obvious that she loves this so much, it'll just be part of her life.
A few tunes seem as beautiful and memorable as familiar movie soundtracks, until you realize this is the first time you've heard them.
If you listen to her music, the CD release, any one of them could be soundtrack music.
Tell me how he is shaping her career now.
Carefully, protectively. We're here, as Quincy said, for the 60 or 70 year run. It's establishing a legitimate musician and composer and a well-adjusted adult.
As long as she wants to play music, we'll support it. But if she decides that she needs a break, then she gets a break. We're supporting her music because she really has a deep enjoyment from it. If you watch her play, she seems happiest when she's composing and playing music.
I'm glad that people like my music and that they're not just listening to like the songs that you can write and produce in the studio in 2 hours with no real instruments.
At this point in his life, Quincy Jones could work with any artist he wants. He chooses to work with Emily Bear.
Our mind is open to the universe and to humanity, you know.
Will her age ever become an obstacle?
I hope she never grows up.
Thank you.